Today we're on page 11 of the AP Chemistry Chapter 5 packet on gases, and we're going to be discussing the difference between real versus ideal gases. So you've heard of the ideal gas law equation, which is PIVNERT, which I'm going to write over here towards the bottom of the page, PV equals NRT. This is the ideal gas law because it assumes two things about the particles. When you're looking at a container of gases, let's say you have three molecules, you're assuming two things about these molecules. Number one, that they don't take up any space, which is not entirely true. And number two, that there are no attractions between the molecules, which is also not entirely true. So because we're making these two assumptions, the ideal gas law is not perfect. It's ideal only if they take up no space and have no attractions. But since in real life they do, we have what's called the real gas law equation, which is the van der Waals gas law equation, which takes into consideration both attractions and size of particles. So we have two corrections for these things. The A is the correction for attractions, and the B is the correction for size. So we have here a chart that lists the A values and the B values of various gases. Let's take a look at helium. Helium is a very small particle. So because it's small, it's going to have a pretty small value for B. Also, helium is nonpolar, so it has London dispersion forces, so its A value for attractions is also quite small. Now, if we take a look at a molecule like water, water attractions are going to be quite high because this has H bonding. So H bonding is a very strong intermolecular force out of the van der Waals forces, which remember are H bond, dipole, dipole, and London dispersion forces. London dispersion are the weakest, they're for nonpolars. Dipole, dipole is for polars. And H bonds are for H attached to either F, O, or N. So since water is H2O, it's attached to an O, it has H bonding. It's also going to be polar, by the way, when you have H bonding. So the correction factor for water is much higher than helium. That makes sense. And also the correction factor for size is greater for water because it's a bigger molecule. So 0.03 versus 0.02, water has a bigger size, so it'll have a bigger B correction factor for volume. So now what we're going to do is you're going to solve the van der Waals equation for this problem. We're going to have, let's try to get this to work here. We're going to have 133 moles of methane. So what we're going to do is we're going to copy down the exact equation as we see it. So P plus A times N squared over V squared, and that whole quantity. Now this is called the pressure observed. I'm going to write OBS for observed, times volume minus NB equals NRT. And actually what I'm going to do is I'm going to space this apart a little bit so I have more room to write all this. Okay, so let's see. We're solving for the P observed. Now we need the A correction factor for methane. Methane is CH4, so the A correction factor is 2.25. So we're going to do 2.25 times N, number of moles, 133, over V, volume, 115, and we're still using those PIVNERT units. Okay, and that's going to be squared for that. Then we times volume, which is 115, minus N, number of moles, is 133, times the B correction factor for methane is going to be this one right here, 0.0428. So 0.0428. And that's going to equal N, which is 133, times R, which is 0.0821, times the temperature in Kelvin, which is going to be 299. Okay, so now this becomes a giant algebra problem. Part of the challenge is keeping all your numbers correct and in the right spot. So I'm going to do the whole right side first. 133 times 0.0821 times 299. That's going to equal, change colors here, 3265. Okay, now on the right side, we're going to do P observed plus 133 divided by 115. And I'm going to square that, multiply by 2.25. That comes out to be 3.01. And then I'm going to take this whole thing, 133 times 0.0428, and I'm going to subtract that from 115. And I get 109. And that's going to now solve for P observed. So divide by 109, 3265 divided by 109 equals, and then we subtract 3.01, and we're going to get 26.9. So this comes out to be 26.9 ATMs, which is a pretty high pressure. And if you think about it, it's because we have so many moles in only 115 liters, so there's going to be a high pressure there, 26.9. Okay, now let's contrast that with solving for Pivnert with the ideal gas law. We'll just solve for P regularly without all the corrections. So the volume is 115 liters. The moles is 133 moles. R is still 0.0821 liter atmospheres per mole Kelvin. Temperature is still 299 Kelvin. And we're just going to take 133 times 0.0821 times 299 divided by 115, and we get 28.4 atmospheres. So you could see that the answers are not that close. They're not that close. So what we find is that the answers are going to be different when the conditions are not that ideal. The reason why these conditions are not so ideal is because you have such a high number of moles. So the most ideal conditions that you can have are to have a low pressure. The most ideal is to have a low pressure, is to have a high volume, is to have a low number of moles, and a high temperature. Those are ideal. We are not that ideal because, in this case, because the pressure is so high, the volume is not too high compared to this number of moles, and the temperature is relatively high, but not significantly. So the point is, this problem is not so ideal. When it's not so ideal, these numbers will be very different. But if we were to do this problem over again, and instead of having 133 moles, let's say we only had 1.33 moles, and did this whole problem over again in both situations, these two numbers would be a lot closer to each other. And that's what you're going to find in your book work towards the end of your assignment, around number 90 or so, where you're going to do a comparison of two different problems and see which one was the more ideal. Okay, lastly, the A and B of water and methane. So if we quickly look at this, water and methane. Water, A, is 5.46, and B is methane is 2.25, and the reason for that is that water has H bond, which is stronger, and CH4 equals London dispersion forces, which is weaker, so it's more ideal when you have nonpolar, no attractions, or very little. Xenon and helium are both nonpolar, so what you do is you look for size. So xenon and helium, here's the xenon size, correction is 0.05, but the helium is 0.02, and that's because helium is a larger atom. So, xenon. Xenon is larger atom because it has more energy levels, so it has a higher B value, which has to do with size.